students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding lengthening shadow over South Asia, written by M.K. Narayanan. Now this editorial broadly is about terrorism. Now this topic of terrorism, it has become quite hot from UPSC point of view. So UPSC can ask an essay on terrorism, a question related to terrorism can be asked in political science optional. And it can be asked in economics optional, how terrorism is disturbing the economic prospects of the world. Or the same question can also be asked in GS mains examination paper 3. Now, this editorial, it is about how terrorism is becoming globalized. How terrorism has changed itself, how terrorism has transformed itself. Now, it is about the lengthening shadow. Now what is meant by the word shadow here? Now shadow here means that the evil forces are expanding. Shadow here means the brutality, the butcherness and the darkness in the world is spreading fast. Shadow here means how the forces that don't believe in peace, that don't believe in human rights, that don't believe in equality, that don't believe in democracy are spreading fast. Shadow here means that the fundamentalism is increasing and getting entrenched. Shadow here means how efforts are being made to institutionalize terror in the world. Shadow here means how the propaganda is affecting the people all over the world. The propaganda of terrorism, the propaganda of militancy, the propaganda of spreading violence. Now, the basic question is how this shadow suddenly has become an issue and how it is spreading and lengthening itself so fast. Now, in order to understand the lengthening process of this terrorism, we need to understand the process of globalization. Initially, when globalization unfolded, it was believed that it will remain more or less confined to the economic aspect, because that is the core aspect for what this globalization stands for. And it was believed that the economic aspects of the globalization will bring about the change in the cultural domain. So these were the twin beliefs, these are the two beliefs of the pioneers of globalization. They had never thought of how this globalization process will lead to the unfolding and unleashing of terrorism, and how terrorism one day will become a globalized force. Today terrorism, it is existing in equivalence with the concept of nation and state. Now, how this process of lengthening has got formed, how this process of lengthening has got entrenched. Now, the basic two reasons that are existing. First is about lack of unanimity. Lack of unanimity of what is right, what is white, what is pure, what is truth, what is rational. So there is no broader unity about what is the righteous path, what is the virtuous path. Now from every religion, the right path is different. Though the end is same, but the path that every religion is teaching to the people, broadly at the face, prima facie, it looks to be quite different. And this is one reason of animosity. When you look at Hinduism, or when you look at Sikhism, or when you look at Jainism, or when you look at Buddhism, broadly, if you generalize their ends, they talk one thing. There is a kind of unanimity in the end thing that they're talking about. But when it comes to the means, and if you subtly differentiate these means, these means are quite contrary. And this is something that has produced fundamentalism. This is something that has created the fault lines. This is something that has created differentiation. This is something that has created gap. This is something that has created hiatus. This is something that has created animosity. This is something that has created disenchantment. This is something that has created acrimony. So we need to do away with this process of lack of unanimity. And how can that happen? Because at the world level, we are not having the process for dialogue, discussion, debate on religion. There's no global platform to discuss about these aspects of religion. So this is need of the hour. In your mains examination in ethics paper, you can mention this aspect. How there is a need to indulge in a dialogue process in order to unleash the truthness of religion, in order to unleash what every religion stands for. Because it's in the name of religion, people are fighting with each other. So lack of unanimity is a big thing that has led to the lengthening of this schedule. And another thing that has led to the lengthening of the schedule is the existing disparity in the world. Now this has to be addressed. And how can this be addressed? This can be addressed if we will be having some kind of mechanism by which the resources, by which the income of the world can be distributed equally. Now, there exists a lot of disparity in the world as per World Bank's reports, as per Oxfam reports, as per IMF report, as per UNDP reports. There exists a lot of disparity in the world. And till the time this disparity will be existing, dissatisfaction, disenchantment will keep on giving birth to grievances of the people. And grievance is the core seed of terrorism. And the third thing is, there should be unanimity in defining what is terrorism. These are the broad three reasons of why this shadow is lengthening. And how to address this lengthening shadow in South Asia. Now, the author of the editorial has focused on how nations like India and Bangladesh, they have put themselves in a state of complacency, how they have put themselves in a state of procrastination, a state of delay by which they are not taking any steps. Now, what kind of steps India and Bangladesh can take? First of all, we need to set up a counter-terrorism force, and that force needs to be fortified with state-of-the-art cyber management, cyber defense technology. Now, what is the cyber defense technology? Cyber defense technology means that this force should be able to tackle terrorism of how it is spreading through this media of internet. This internet has become a kind of a big communication link. This internet is the basic reason of proliferation and globalization of terrorism. Now the people become aware of the lectures, of the ideologies, of the philosophies of the people who are interested in propagating this terrorism. On YouTube you will find n number of videos of the people belonging to ISIS who want to spread their message, and this is what is generating lone wolf attack system. They have created this realm of lone wolf attacks, and this is something that is very bad for the humanity. And if you really want to address this on a holistic scale, we need to take multiple steps. First of all, address disparity, address the issue of fundamentalism in religion, and strengthen yourself as a military nation and as a nation that can tackle the challenges that are coming from the front of cyber world. The cyber world is moving out of hand. Now, when you look at the global level, at the level of UN, we don't have a treaty for terrorism. And we don't have a cyber security treaty at the global level. And at the global level, we don't have an organization for religion. We don't have a mechanism of how the wealth should be divided equally among the nations. So all these actions broadly if taken would help in shortening the shadow. And this can happen only out of the political will of the global leaders. So these kind of topics are generalized topics. So in these editorial classes, I try to build up an opinion about the topic so that you can generate your own thought, because it is the thought development that really matters in the mains examination. Without the development of thought, you will not be able to write in the mains examination. Your pen will not move on the mains examination sheet. So this is all for the editorial decode. Subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. In order to avail the information, visit brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice time.